Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to John's Model Making. Today we got issue 99 of the Spitfire. Yes, the last issue once we get to the diorama, because we've already done 100. Now in this we do get everything to do with the pilot, the cockpit, there's other details as well for some of the panels at the front. There's a Pitot tube that goes underneath the Spitfire. Well, I can understand why they left that till the end, but anyway. Also in the instructions, just have a quick look at the instructions. There we go. We don't need to do anything where the base is concerned, where the batteries, stick them in place, because they have given us some pads as well, because I'm running out of an external power supply. So here we have the details. That's just a screw cover and them two other panel on the engine. And then it's just a case of put the pilot with his seat belt in place, and then it's all the details for the cockpit. Now I will be using, I've mentioned this before, I think, micro crystal clear. I won't be using super glue on any of these. This dries clear. It takes a little while to set, but it's excellent glue. Won't fog anything. So that's all the detail there. Yep, and that is it. Now the instructions do show you how to connect it up, but we've already tested it a few times anyway. So that is that for now. We can also have a look at a quick look, yep, through the magazine. The Iraqi counterattack. When the Imperial Japanese Army went on the offensive, the Iraqi Peninsula RAF Spitfire units encountered Japanese fighters and bombers supporting troops on the ground. And in the main picture, pilots from number 607 County of Durham Squadron at Ramu in January 1944. Picture number two, Spitfire Mark 8 of number 81 Squadron at Imphal in February 1944. And number three, we have number 136 Squadron used the tail fin from a down Ki-46 diner as its scoreboard during the Burma campaign. Excellent stuff. Oh, next page, Germany's Eastern Allies, Slovakia and Bulgaria. Two of Germany's Eastern Allies switched sides before the end of World War II. So Slovakia first fought against the USSR and then alongside it, while Bulgaria tried to avoid combat with Russia before joining forces against its former German partner. Some excellent pictures here as well. On 16th of June 1944, 158 Liberator bombers attacked a refinery, docks and bridge across the River Danube in Bratislava, Slovakia. Excellent stuff. They're cracking, read these stories. Really are historically very, very accurate, of course. And here we have a picture of an ace Bulgarian pilot, Pitot Angelov Bochev, who downed five enemy aircraft. I think that's the King of Bulgaria with Hitler. There we go. And obviously we've done issue 100. So without further ado, that is it for the magazine and the parts. So I'll say again, without further ado, let's get on with the build. Okay, though, parts for issue 99. We have a pilot. Yes, there he is. Whoops, dropped him. He's looking in really good condition as well. Let's have a look at his eyes. There you go, virtually non-existent, grey, steely-eyed. Needs to be. There we go, sits nicely. We'll put him in the plane later. Obviously we're going to have to glue all these parts, because it's all about the cockpit canopy. We've got a lens, a mirror, gun sight, support for the gun sight, canopy hood latch, a Pitot tube, panel plugs right and left, oil cap, the pilot obviously, the seat belt. There is battery box stickers and a circuit board sticker, but we won't be using them because I'm using external power supply with this. Now first thing it wants us to do is to add the detail to that engine cover panel, so I'll just grab that. There we go, we got two pieces of detail for the engine cover. Yep, excellent. There you go, here and here, there and there. Now we'll be using some micro crystal clear for this, I don't fancy using super glue on any of this, so bear with me. There we go, that's them two pieces of detail in place now. Excellent. It does dry clear this. If you do get any run over, don't worry about it too much, just clear the excess and it does dry clear. Okay, up next thing, we need the pilot and his seat belt. Now we'll put this on the plane later, like I said earlier, but we can put the seat belt over the pilot, hopefully. Do it that way. There we go. Feels a little brittle, that, to be honest. I'm not sure. You could be very careful with it. Yeah, I won't like to bend it too much. But there we go. Right, there we go, that's the seat belt over the pilot. Just need to pop that into the plane now, along with that panel later. Now we can put the gun sight together. Need this piece, put that to one side there, and this piece goes into here. Now that is, yep, about there for it. So to pop in something like that, we're gonna have to glue this. It's very, very tiny. There we go, that's it in situ. There we go, very, very tiny, but we just need to let that set now. Okay, now we've got the parts for the canopy. This one I've already popped in. It fits in, there we go, there you can see, there. So that is, doesn't need any glue, that one. This piece, obviously you can see where it's slanted to the front there. This again we can just place in here and just clip it in on the other side. There we go, that's that piece in place. You don't have to glue this in, you just have to support it and press the tabs into the slots, into the green frame. There we go, and they come through there, those four slots. Once you're happy, won't need any glue at all, that one. Okay, now we've got the hood latch, which is that piece. There we go. Now there's a little slot in there, it goes there. Oops. But you, the detail, this side of it goes onto the inside of that cockpit there, like that. There you go, so I'll just glue that in place. Now we've got the mirror, so we need to take this yellow backing off. There we go, use the cocktail stick in the end. You can remove the protective blue film as well, that is on it, when you're ready. There you go, that's the mirror. Then we need to add this bracket on the back into there. Now this one we can use super glue. It's entirely up to you which glue you use. That fits something like, oops, that, where you can see where the two holes are, where it fits. There we go, that's that piece glued in place now. You can see the white glue that will set clear, so I'll just need to wait for that to dry before putting in place. And there we got the front of the canopy. Again, this is it's got two pegs to fit into the aircraft, but what we do need is it's sat like that, and we can see where it fits. It's a little bit tough on this side. It's fitting nicely there on this side, but here it's struggling a little bit. So just bear with me. There we go. I was afraid that was going to break, but it is in place now. Excellent. It is a very tight fit. The instructions even said so. You don't need any glue for that, thank God. But that is now in place. Excellent. Okay, that just leaves us with the Pitot tube and that screw cover to fit onto the plane. So there we go, that's everything in place now. The pilot with the seat belt, the mirror, the gun sight, that's the cover for a screw, the Pitot tube, the engine cover, and the cockpit pieces are all ready to be installed on the aircraft. Okay, first thing we can do, we can fix the gun sight onto this cover I've taken off the aircraft. There's just two pegs, one, two, and that just fits on there like that. And just need to glue that into place. Just like that. There we go. Excellent. Pop that back on the craft now. We also get a lens for here. Hopefully that will just drop into place, and it does drop into place, but it is loose, so I'll use some of that glue, micro crystal clear on it. Okay, I've applied the glue there, and that will drop in place. Now that will set. That's already looking brilliant. I've just popped the pilot in place. That seatbelt does get in the way a little bit. There, it just clips at the back there, and we can bring the joystick forward so as he can handle that. There we go. That's our fellow pilot in place. Excellent. And there's that panel back in place, along with the gun sight. Now we can start putting the cockpit canopy in place. That one goes there. It does say to glue it in place. It is a rather loose fit, that. Well, that's fine for now. There we have that engine cover in place with the details there and there. This piece of the canopy, I've glued one side, just in case I do need to take it off. And I'm going to do this same with the front piece of the canopy. Just a little bit of glue on that one there, so it's only held in by one side, just in case I do need to take it off. And the other side, I'll get that one in first. The other side will clip in place. There it is. There we go. Excellent. And the mirror is now in place. Now the other part of the canopy, obviously you got the latch. Here we are. There's the latch. So you must make sure you don't hit his head with it. So push it in one side. There we go. Because it will only go so far back. How are we supposed to get out? I don't know, but anyway. There it is. That's the cockpit canopy in place. And we need the screw cover for here. That just drops in. I might glue that later. wait and see. All that's left now is the Pitot tube underneath. There you go, that's that canopy on with the door up. Excellent. Okay, let's give it one more test flight. There we go, folks, that's it. That is issue 99 complete. The aircraft is there on its base, if you've just seen. Sorry about the shaky camera, but it's working fine. The Pitot tube is under that. I couldn't show you that, it was just impossible to balance it and then stick it in with a bit of super glue on the end of it, but that's looking fine. I think you could see it in the video anyway. But everything's in place. There are some gapping issues, that's why I've not glued everything fully, so as I can remove things, but everything is secure, so that is fine. If I do come across an easy fix for that gapping, I'll certainly let you know. We do know it's the front of the craft, it just dips, it's just too heavy and it's not supported back. If you push it back, you can see the gaps close up nicely. But that is it, that's issue 99 done. So all we've got now is the diorama. There are two videos out for the diorama, so look out for them. They'll be with you shortly. Anyway, the only thing we can do is have a quick look at the magazine, but we've already done that, so nothing else to do. There we are, issue 99 complete. Excellent stuff. And obviously this is issue 100. It's not as bad as I thought it was going to be, that, to be honest. It's going to be invaluable. There we go, excellent stuff. Well, all that leaves us to do now is to say ta-ra. But if you did enjoy that, give us a big thumbs up, subscribe, hit that notification bell, and I'll see you next month sometime for the diorama. Anyway, I think, like I said before, I have got two other videos for 107, 108, and 109, and 110. The videos for that will be up in the next few days, and then after that it'll be another month before we get anything off Hachette, and I'll let you know how I get on with the motor and other issues that I may have with Hachette over this build. Thanks for watching, stay safe, bye for now.